Greetings and welcome. This is your Polish-American Connection TV show, and I'm your host, Tom Gajewski. A couple of reminders. First of all, this is an interactive program, and if you have a comment or a question that you want to make, feel free to give us a call at 610-378-0426. 610-378-0426. We just ask that if you have a comment or question that you make your comment or state your question and then give the person it's directed to a chance to answer so we can move on and get through the rest of the program and maybe get to some other callers that might be interested in calling in. Tonight, in this program, we have two special guests to talk to us about two fun events that are coming up. You know, summertime is a time when there's a lot of fun, a lot of sun, a lot of picnics, a lot of polka dances, a lot of activities, and this year is certainly no exception. So we're going to talk about two of those things that are coming up here on the program. Thanks, first of all, to our first guest, John Bruszak, whose voice is well known in our community. He's the person who takes the phone calls on Walter Kay's Polka Party program, and he's a longtime polka promoter. He's been involved in Polish activities, and he was involved with the Polish American Heritage Association since going back to somewhere around 95. Even before he moved to Florida, he was involved in the Polish community very heavily. So, John, welcome. We're glad to have you here tonight.
Thanks for having me, Tom.
You bet. And you have a special event coming up on Sunday, June the 11th. June 12th. Want to tell us about it?
Oh, yes. I'm a cancer survivor. I had cancer in 2000, and it's kind of payback time. The Cancer Society was good to me when I was going through my rehab and during my cancer time. So I said, now let's have a dance, and we're going to help support the Cancer Society. And I'm bringing a band in from Pittsburgh, known by the name of Bud Hadensky. He's kind of the big band sound. He has about 8 members in his band. And he also has a guest vocalist. The vocalist is Eddie Biegai. Eddie Biegai used to have his own band. He has appeared in Reading quite a few times. Very, very popular young man. And he can really sing, and he really gets the crowd going. So we're going to be having the dance at the Goodwill Fire Company Banquet Hall at 100 Madison Avenue. And everybody's invited out to come out and help support the fund. And so we can help beat this silent killer known as cancer. Every time I talk to people and they tell me their relative died of cancer, their daughter has cancer, their son has cancer. It's tough because it is a disease that is really, really tough on the families because everybody gets involved when somebody has cancer. We also are going to be having a Chinese raffle, and we have a lot of good prizes when you come out, and you'll see the fun everybody's having. You don't have to dance. You can just come out and enjoy the music, enjoy the camaraderie. We have people calling us from North Carolina, New Jersey, Pittsburgh, New York. They're coming from all over. I hope the local people support us like the people from out of town do. And there's going to be an event that takes place during the dance. The Polka America Corporation is going to be presenting an award to Bud Hadensky and his orchestra for the best Polish CD put out by a polka band in 2010. They're coming in from New Jersey, and the vice president of the company is going to be here, and it's going to be quite an event. I'm proud that they've selected our dance to do this. It gives you an idea that people appreciate what goes on in our community. And tickets are available. They're only $15. Where can you go for $15 and have 4 hours of great fun, camaraderie, and just having a blast. And tickets can be gotten from my wife Sally at 610-404-0016 or Dolores Taris at 610-779-4329 or Walt DeKay, the disc jockey for Walt DeKay's Polka Party, at 610-375-3051 and Linda Roble at 610-372-7673. I wish everybody would come out and just have a good time. And you're going to be meeting, I'm hoping, some polka band members that aren't playing or aren't busy that day are coming out and make an appearance at our place. I know some disc jockeys that are hoping to attend, and we should have a great time, Tom.
And John, besides the good time that you're planning to have there, and it sounds like it'll be great, all the money goes to the Berks County unit, so it stays right here in the community.
It stays right here in Berks County, yes. Jesse Rivera is my coordinator. She and I work together with the Cancer Society, and it's going real well.
Mm-hmm. That's good. And congratulations to you and the people that are helping you put this together, because I know it takes a lot of work to do a polka dance. I've been involved in a couple myself.
Well, the nice thing is every time you go and you talk to people, merchants especially, about what we're doing, how we're doing it, they're always eager to help. Mm-hmm. That's one of the nice things about working in the community. You're dealing with local people, mm-hmm. and they appreciate that you're sponsoring an event where they can partake in it and be recognized. So that's what we try to do.
And like you say, this is providing the best of keeping the Polish culture alive and entertainment alive, and at the same time, it's going, the proceeds are going to a very good cause.
Yes, people don't realize that what the local society can do for you. Somebody told me about it. I hadn't realized what they could do. And they do wonderful things to help you, such things as getting you drivers to take you to and from your chemo treatment or radiation treatment. They do a lot of things to make it easier on the family, not only you, but on the family, which is nice, because when I had to have 30 drivers to take me for radiation, I was lucky. I had two schools that had a lot of teachers, and they all volunteered to take me back and forth for my radiation to Allentown. But they said, you know, if you need help, call us up, we'll get somebody to drive you. And that's great, because there's a lot of people who can't do it.
John is a true survivor too. He's been through cancer, and he's also been through a very serious automobile accident. And with God's help, you came through both of those things with shining colors, and here you are running a polka dance.
They always say God's saving you for some event, and every time I do something, I'm wondering if that's the event. Because, you wonder sometimes, but my number hasn't come up yet. But when it does, I'm ready.
And so I don't get in trouble, I better say, with God's help and Sally's help, right?
Oh, there you are. She's my nurse, believe me. She got me through thick and thin.
Well, I'm sure the Polish community, and I'm sure the people at the Cancer Society and the people who are affected by cancer appreciate all that you do, John.
Thank you. And I can just say one thing. If you've never been to a polka dance, you ought to come out and just see what goes on, because you're going to say, wow, we had one heck of a good time. Mm-hmm. And you do, and you don't, the time flies, it goes like that. Mm-hmm. So, but, hope to see you on June the 12th, time is 2 to 6, doors open at 1. Come on out, join us, and have fun. Meet a lot of friends.
And it's $15 whether you pay early or come and pay at the door, right?
It's one price, yeah.
Okay.
So, if anybody has any questions, we're here to seek an answer for you.
And you'll have some food there as well.
Oh, we're going to have food. The Goodwill Fire Company, they have a lot of food, and they'll also have the bar wide open.
Mm-hmm.
And If you like that zimno piwo, as they say in Polish, that cold beer, please come on out and have a great time.
Very good. Well, thank you for what you're doing, and we really appreciate it. And why don't we, at this time, BCTV usually asks for a minute to take a brief break, so why don't we at this time go to a break?
At bctv.org, we're all about creating community. On our website, we provide a forum for citizen journalists, people just like you, to post articles. Then the community can comment on those articles. We love dialogue. In fact, you can comment on just about anything on our website, not just the articles. You can comment on BCTV programs, calendar events, and blogs, too. Just log in to join the discussion. We want to keep the discussion going, but we need your help. Please consider becoming a member of BCTV. It's only $35, and your contribution creates community.
Okay, we want to thank John Bruschek for being here and talking about the Polka versus Cancer that's coming up on Sunday and June 12th, and we hope you attend. And we're going to have that information on the screen for you so you can make note of it a little bit later on. But next, we'd like to go to John Donowski, who is representing St. Cyril's and is co-chairman of the picnic, their annual church picnic. And this is, I guess, your 11th year, John?
The 11th year that I've been one of the co-chairmen.
Mm-hmm. And how many years, do you have any rough idea how many years St. Cyril's has been doing an annual picnic?
I would bet at least 50. I know at one point it used to be a twice a year event. We used to have one in June and another in August, but we just do the one in June now.
Why don't you, if you would, tell our viewers when, where, how much, and all the details.
Okay. Our picnic is going to be on Sunday, June 26th from noon to 6, and we hold it at St. Benedict's Picnic Grove, which is on Route 10 in Plowville. It's 4541 Morgantown Road, and that's about 9 miles south from Lancaster Avenue on Route 10. We'll have music from the Pennsylvania Villagers from 2 to 6, and they are always a good band, have a nice following. We also do a raffle. We have a silent auction. We do a bingo from 1 to 5. We do pony rides from 2 to 4, and those are courtesy of Gallman Sanowski Funeral Home. So we try to do events that would have the whole family involved, you know, from young to old. And probably one of the bigger things we like to lay claim to is the food. The food is homemade, and we have halupki, which is the stuffed cabbage, halushki, kabasi sandwiches, pierogies, potato pancakes, which is, we're probably one of the few people that still do that anymore, and that's always a popular event. If you come out for those, be prepared to wait in line. And we have two different soups, a garden vegetable and a ham and bean soup, and then hamburgers and hot dogs and, you know, usually homemade cakes and pastries from the ladies of the parish. So there's something that should please everybody.
And John, all this food is made by volunteers, and it's all homemade, am I right?
That's right.
Yeah. So a lot of good food, a lot of good Slovak food, a lot of good Polish food.
Right.
Yep. So it'll be something really to look forward to. And the band this year is, again?
Is the Pennsylvania Villagers.
Okay.
And they'll be playing from 2 to 6.
Mm-hmm. And is there an admission fee?
Oh, that's right. We ask for a $2 donation, and that's to help cover the cost of the rental of the grounds and also for the band.
But $2 to get into a picnic like that with that all that entertainment and then the opportunity to buy that food?
Right.
Can't beat it, right?
That's right.
And you'll have plenty of zimno pivo, too.
That's correct.
Are you a bartender?
No, I'm on patrol during the day.
And, of course, Father Spurlock will be there.
That's right.
Yeah.
Father Spurlock is always in charge of the weather that day.
Yeah.
And 95% of the time he comes through.
And I was going to say, he gets his request in early, doesn't
yes.
he?
Yes, he sure does.
And like you say, there's pony rides for the kids.
Mm-hmm.
And what do you charge for a pony ride?
We do not charge for that.
Oh, really?
We get that donated by Steve Sanosky from the Gallman Sanosky Funeral Home.
Mm-hmm.
So we don't charge for that. We figure that's a bonus. Let the kids ride it. You know, you can ride as many times from the 2 to 4s. You can get in line again and go on the ponies.
And if you want a chance at winning something too, you can go over and play some bingo.
That's right.
And that goes on, is that the whole time of the picnic?
The bingo goes from 1 to 5,
mm-hmm.
and we do half of what we take in. So if we take in $10 that game, mm-hmm. then, you know, we keep 5 and you get 5. So
it's like a 50-50.
50-50, though, bingo. That's right.
Different kind, yeah, okay. And again, run down those foods, because I know there's some people out there who like to come to these picnics just to eat the good food.
Okay. We have haluki, which is the stuffed cabbage with rice. Halushki, which is the fried cabbage and onion and butter mixed in with the potato dough, the noodles. Kibasi sandwiches on a roll, you know, with or without sauerkraut. We do potato pierogies with the, you know, mixed in with the onions and butter. The potato pancakes, if you've never had them, that's basically grated potatoes, eggs, flour, onion, and then it's mixed together, and then you deep fry it. And some people like it with ketchup, some people do it with applesauce. You know, that's all your prerogative, but they are very good. We do homemade soups. We're going to have a garden vegetable this year and a ham and bean soup and hamburgers and hot dogs. And once again, you know, we do have a lot of homemade cakes, cupcakes, and things like that. We've already had chocolate covered strawberries. So there's quite a variety of it. You know, you have to come earlier for the best selection.
And plotskis, there's a lot of work that goes into making plotski.
Yes, it is.
You have to make all that up beforehand, and then it takes time to fry it and all that. And I know that's one of my favorites, so I'll be looking forward to that.
And it takes time to peel. I think we use 75 pounds of potatoes. So
wow.
That's a lot of peeling between that and the onions. So
just to carry all that is a job. And all the proceeds from this goes to help St. Cyril's Church.
That's right.
Okay. Any particular project, or just to help the church?
Probably more some maintenance with the church over the years. You know, if we've upgraded the electricity in the church or in the basement, different things, the lighting in the church. Mm-hmm. So we help out wherever things are needed. This is run through our parish guild, and we help out as, you know, wherever we can.
Mm-hmm. And John, for the folks out there who might not know where the church is located, can you tell them that?
St. Cyril and Methodius, we're at 6th and Laurel Streets in Reading. If you're coming off the Bingham Street Bridge, it's 2 blocks, and it's on the left-hand corner, right across the street from Santos Sandwich Shop.
And Mass is open to anyone.
That's right. Mass is open to anyone. We have Mass Saturday at 4 p.m., Sunday at 8 a.m. and 10:30. Mm-hmm. And usually 8 o'clock in the morning during the week.
Mm-hmm. Very good. And St. Cyril's has been there for certainly as long as I can remember, and a mm-hmm. lot longer than that. So
1895 we were founded.
Wow. So it's more than 100 years old.
Mm-hmm.
And same location the whole time?
Same location, yes.
Wow. And I guess there were updates made to the church over the years, quite a few.
Over the years, yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So if you want to come into one of the historical churches of Reading to see what it's like and see what the Mass is like, you're certainly welcome to do that. And you're also welcome to come out to the picnic to support what goes on at the church as well. And you're guaranteed to have a good time, because not only is the food great, but the entertainment's great. Jim the Pivo, Jim the Suddy. So there'll be a lot of things there for just about anybody. And then pony rides and bingo on top of it.
Right.
So you always have a good turnout, too.
We do.
Yeah, even when the weather's not as good, you still have a good turnout there.
Yes. Mm-hmm. We have a lot of faithful people that come year in, year out. If you've never been to St. Benedict's, it is a nice level area. We have designated parking in the front row. If you know, if you have a handicap parking placard or you need to be closer for that, you know, we're accommodating that way. And everything is pretty level. So it's, we've had picnics at some other places where there were hills and things like that. This is a pretty nice area to have it.
And there is a big pavilion there, and if you want to take advantage of that, if the weather wouldn't be as good, or if you want to make sure you get into a spot where it's covered, get there early so that you get a spot.
Pavilion, there are a lot of trees, there is a lot of shade, so it's a nice area to have a picnic.
What time does your committee start to get there so that people can come in and sit down and find themselves a place to park?
We generally get there at 8. And a lot of that is just unloading the trucks, getting the food on, getting the tent set up and everything. That there's probably a good 2 hours of setup and making sure everything's ready to go.
And what time do you get to bed at Sunday night?
Maybe 10.
Maybe 10 if you're lucky, huh? And again, all this food is made by volunteers.
Yes.
Yeah. That's what makes it special. A lot of these recipes have been around, too, for generations.
Mm-hmm.
They sell any bread there? Do you know?
We may have a little bit. Mm. We don't normally have a ton of it. We might do that for some other fundraisers that we have.
Okay. And I know you do other things like rummage sales during the year, too. So
we do rummage sales. Usually it's the weekend before Thanksgiving.
Mm-hmm.
And we just had a big Memorial Day breakfast. So we do a lot of different things.
Very good. Well, John, thank you for all that you do and the people that are helping you with this picnic, too. And I know it's a success because of your work.
So I'd
like to thank both of you for being here. And we have some music that John Bruschak brought that's from the band that's going to be playing at the Polka versus Cancer event. John, you want to?
Yes, it's Bud Hudensky, and on the vocal will be Eddie Biegai. He is the vocalist supreme, but there's other vocalists with the polka band too. So you will be getting all kind of music. And they don't only play polkas, they play some modern music and they kind of meet what the crowd would like, but primarily it's polkas.
Very good. If we could start, thank you both for being here. I really appreciate it, and I appreciate what you guys are doing, and I know that the people in the community do as well.
Thanks for having us. Thank you.
Sure. If we could start with the events that are coming up, and we'll play that music while we're taking a look. Again, this is the Polka versus Cancer. It's at the Goodwill Fire Company in Hyde Park on Sunday, June 12th from 2 to 6 p.m. Bud Hudensky with Eddie Biega. And you can call Dolores at 610-779-4923 or John at 610-404-0016. Polish American Heritage Association has their monthly meeting on Thursday, June 16th at 6 o'clock at the Goggle Works, 2nd and Washington Streets in room 325. Guests are welcome, and there's free parking in the rear of the building. There's a trip to Ellis Island, Statue of Liberty, sponsored by the Polish American Heritage Association on Saturday, June 25th. For information, call Marilyn at 610-779-5523, and then you can recover for the next day at St. Cyril's Picnic. St. Cyril's Annual Picnic, Sunday, June 26th, noon to 6 p.m. at St. Benedict's Grove, Route 10, south of Reading, featuring the Pennsylvania villagers, and you heard about all that good homemade Slovak and Polish food. Summer Polka Blast at Sunnybrook Ballroom, Pottstown, Pennsylvania, July 17th, noon to 8 p.m., featuring Chicago Push, Dennis Poliski, and the Maestro Men, the Osage Rhythm and Music Trio as well. Polish American Heritage Association has their annual picnic on Sunday, July 24th at the Lower Alsace Fire Company at the Picnic Grove at Roosevelt and Columbia Avenues in Stony Creek Mills, and you can call Nadine at 610-736-3035. Polish American T-shirts, infant child and adult sizes. Children are $9.95, adults $14.95. Get more information at www.looseends.biz. Polish American Heritage Association is sponsoring Wish and Anki classes for $20. Call Marilyn at 610-779-5523. If you're interested in learning how to make some of this good Polish food, there's a class that's being formed. If you're interested, they're trying to determine the amount of interest. Call Marilyn at 610-779-5523. Polka shows on the radio, Kaz's German Bavarian Polka Show on Sundays from 10 to 12 on 8:30 a.m. WEEU. Walter K's Polka Party on Sunday from 10 to 1, 1340 a.m. WREW. And Janet and John Osuch Saturday from 11 a.m. And that's on 1390 a.m. out of Pottstown. Polish American Cultural Room on the fifth floor of the Goggle Works, second in Washington Streets, Reading, Saturday and Sunday from 11 to 4, free admission and free parking. Until next time, which will be the first Tuesday in July, can you believe it, the middle of summer, at the same time, same station, please tune in. For tonight, thank you for watching. This is Tom Gajewski saying, take care of yourself, God bless you, and always be proud to be Polish.